Take one step outside yourself. The whole path lasts no longer than one step.
No trace. No trace. No trace. No trace. No trace. No trace. When we practice Zazen, our mind is calm and quite simple. No trace. But usually our mind is very busy and complicated. No trace. And it is difficult to be concentrated on what we are doing. No trace. This is because before we act, we think. No trace. And this thinking leaves some trace. Our activity is shadowed by some preconceived idea. The thinking not only leaves some trace or shadow, but also gives us many other notions about other activities and things. These traces and notions make our minds very complicated. When we do something with a quite simple, clear mind, we have no notion or shadows. But when we do something with a complicated mind, in relation to other things or people or society, our activity becomes very complex. No trace. No trace. No trace. No trace. No trace. Most people have a double or triple notion. Activity. There is a saying, to catch two birds with one stone. That is what people usually try to do. Relative mind is the mind which sets itself in relation to other things, thus limiting itself. It is this small mind which creates gaining ideas and leaves traces of itself. If you leave a trace of your thinking on your activity, you will be attached to the trace. For instance, you may say, "This is what I have done." But actually, it is not so. In your recollection, you may say, "I did such and such a thing in some certain way." But actually, that is never exactly what happened. When you think in this way, you limit the actual experience of what you have done. So if you attach to the idea of what you have done, you are involved in selfish ideas. Often we think what we have done is good, but it may not actually be so. When we become old, we are very often proud of what we have done. Because they want to catch too many birds, they find it difficult to be concentrated on one activity, and they may end up not catching any birds at all. That kind of thinking always leaves its shadow on their activity. The shadow is not actually the thinking itself. Of course, it is often necessary to think or prepare before we act, but right thinking does not leave any shadow. Thinking which leaves traces. No trace. No trace. In order not to leave any traces, when you do something, you should do it with your whole body and mind. You should be concentrated on what you do. You should do it completely, like a good bonfire. You should not be a smoky fire. You should burn yourself completely.